Shalom, I'm Kes, and welcome to my channel. This is my class 1 build for a soccer competition coming up for my son E.T. It's a joint venture between me and him. He built the chassis and the frame and everything, and I'm building the body. And I'm building it by soccer rules, at least the 22 rules, because in 23 they're changing the rules a bit. So what is class 1? Class 1 is basically our Jeep, our Ute, our pickup, the car that we bought at the dealership, but now we want to take it off-road. So we want to make it a bit more capable. We put a winch in, we change our bumpers to something that's a bit more effective, put undersides that will protect our car. Make it a bit more off-roadish, but it's still road legal. It's a crawler, but it's road legal. So this is my class 1 build. I'm just going to go through the rules and what you can do and what you can't do for class 1 and what the difference is from class 2 basically. This is an RTR. Any RTR these days almost comes as a class 2 just because the size of the wheel. Okay, the class 1 has got a smaller wheel. It's not the wheel that we come from the dealership. That's the class 0. This is a better crawler wheel, opted for off-roading, but small, so it's road legal. So that's our class 1 truck. Our bumpers in class 1, we have to build bumpers that are at least the width of the widest part of the front windshield, which means these points here, okay? And the back bumper has to be wider than your body. That's an obligation in class 1 that you have to have. Another thing you can't do, you can't shorten the sides of the car. It has to stay the height that it is. And you're not allowed to touch any of the wheel wings too much. You can clear them a bit, but not too much. Your wheels, by 2022 soccer rules, have to be at least 50% covered by your body, which means I can't do a dovetail in the back or pinch it in the front. I can't do that. I have to leave the body as it is with its width. In 2023, you are allowed to bring your wheels out a bit wider from the body, which means you can have a wider car. Not necessarily good if you want to go for a gate of 28 centimeters. You have to have inner fenders. Your car has to be covered on the bottom. You mustn't show any of your parts of your electronics. They should all be covered up. That is a specific rule. And you must have a windshield. You can't take your windshield out. Basically, those are the rules. You can go into soccer and read them all, but that's what I general look around. And then when I build the truck, I go really go into the rules and try to find the gray areas, of course. And this what I've done with this body. As you can see, this is a Ford Bronco, and it's not a pickup. This is a full body. What I've done is I've taken the roof off. Well, that used to be there. I cut it off. This is legal. This way the car is called a full car and not a cab, so I get more points on it. I've also bobbed the back. As you can see, this doesn't fit anymore. I've bobbed the back so it's a bit shorter. Also in the rules, it's a full body as long, if I take this off, it's a full body as long as I've got a full interior. I have to have a full interior in the back, and it has to be shown. So only then is it considered a full body. Otherwise, it's not. If you cut this part off and you don't have the seats and everything else inside, it's not considered a full body. You won't get the points. So make sure of that if you do anything like this. I just want to show you before I keep on going to the rules or to the class 1 pick sheet. My body is mounted with magnets. I've got 4 magnets on my skids. I've got 2 pins that are going to go in the back, hidden in here. And I've got my winch lead coming out of the front. So basically, it's going to be held. At the moment, it's just with the magnets. And as you can see, they do pretty well. I love these medium baggers. They really hold the trucks well. They also transfer my electricity to the truck itself. So let's go through the tech sheet The tech sheet is something we get before every competition, so we can check our truck and make sure it's all legal and check the points before we start. You are in class one, you're allowed to go up to 61 points. So this is a Ford Bronco with a full body, and it's custom built by me. So I get full body points minus 12. I get a custom built body to carry it. Full body, it's a minus 4. With inner fenders front and back, that's minus 1 on each of those. That's minus 18 just for that, all of that. Then I'm going to have my bumpers. They're still being made. I'm going to have a front bumper with a grill guard or a stinger. That's extra points. So steel bumpers front and rear. That's minus 6 altogether. I'm not going to build a roof rack. I've got no need for it. Metal sliders. I've installed metal sliders. I get extra points for metal sliders instead of plastic. You get points on plastic, just not as much. I haven't got any leaf springs, so I don't get any points on the chassis points. I do get a front servo, of course, because my servo is chassis mounted. Interior. My interior is extra handmade. It's extra custom handmade, so I get extra points for that. It's a four-seater, so I get minus 5 points instead of a two-seater. I get more points for that. And for our human figures that are sitting in, I've got two full human figures inside, so I get full points for them. You get less points if their knees up, if their torso up, or if they're just head and shoulders, but you still get points for that. So I've got all of those points. And then we go on to accessories, non-functional and functional. The non-functional are wipers, windshields, I've got an exhaust pipe in the back, headlights are non-functional, right? No, functional. Non-functional, you also have an antenna. The hubs that I have, a high lift in there, it's all non-functional items that sit in your car. You can accessorize as much as you want. If you get minus 6 points for that, so it's always worth using those. The functional items. The functional items are toe strap, D-rings, any scale accessories that you have, headlights, tail lights, you get extra points for that. And for a front winch, if you've got a back winch, you also get points for that. For the vehicle itself, if it's a tube bed, or if you have a roll bar, I don't have a roll bar in mine yet. I'm going to put it in. I don't need it for the competition because all I've set up till now, I'm up to 62 points already for the soccer comp. So I can have only 60. I don't have to add a roll bar. I'll add it eventually because I'd like to protect the people's heads. Well, that's ET's class 1 tech sheet. He's up to 62 points before the comp. So he's doing very, very well. This is my car for the comp. It's not as much. I've got about 50 scale points. I'm trying to try and get some more. And they're both Element Builders kits. I really love them. This is a 3D printed shell. This is a shell that I bought from AliExpress. And of course, did a lot of work on it. Painting and scuffing and bobbing and cutting, of course, and fixing up. But I build these trucks to drive you around, not for the actual comp. So it doesn't really look like a comp truck. It should work pretty good at the competition, but I'm not expecting too much. No, especially not the guys with the G-speeds and the comp, really, really comp trucks that I'm going up against. I drive this car all year round, and that's what I focus on. Actual car that we can drive around all year round, not the actual competition. but I still go by the soccer rules, so I can and go to the competitions. I'm not going to build a special truck just to comp. I'm Cass. I hope you like my reviews. Please like, share, subscribe. Shalom.
Hit the strobe. Hit the strobe. Hit the strobe.